Biff's Gaming Videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Swimmers and my guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from Biff Sun.
Fun.
This is Ballblazer for the Atari 5200 Super System. It came out from LucasFilm Games before they came LucasArts, along with Rescue on Fractalus. Basically, the game is set in the year 3097, and you have a rotofoil. It's split into top and bottom, so it's a two-player game or one-player game versus the computer. It's kind of like soccer in space. You move around, you grab a ball, and you shoot it towards the goalpost at the end of the screen. The goalpost moves left and right, so it's always moving, and farther away you score the point, the more points you get. So you want to shoot from really far away if you can to get more points. And then once the timer is up or you get so many points, the game is over. This has really, really, really cool sound. This is the first game that constantly changed or improvised the sound based on gameplay. So the music didn't play and just cut out, it would just change as different things went on, which is really cool. And it was years and years and years later before other companies started picking up on that. This is kind of infamous along with Rescue on Fractalus because Atari in May of 82 had a deal with LucasFilm to set up a division to release games for the Atari systems, and in May of 84, they came out with these two games. Atari wanted to hold back on the Atari 800 version, so released it on the 5200, and then later they released it to the 7800, still holding back the 800 version. Eventually, in 86, when the 800 versions were released for the two games, which both games are like top-notch, really, really good games. If you take a look at them, they're just fantastic looking for a little tiny video game system at that time. But eventually, by 86, they were released by Epix, and the whole industry had been long since gone and so forth, and it didn't look as good as, you know, getting an Atari ST or Commodore or Amiga. So there's a whole thing there, and that's why Lucas stopped designing games for Atari. And these two games had gotten on the bulletin board services, basically two computers hooked up to each other is how that did before people got on the internet. Everybody had the games already for the 800 computers, so when they released it, no one really bought it. But still, this is a 5200 version, and it's one of the best 5200 games there are. I'm giving this game an A. It's got great sound. It looks great. I mean, it's just, I would challenge anybody to take a few K ROM and do something like this. It's dang near impossible. Both of these games from LucasFilm were way ahead of their times, years and years later before someone could even do something like this.